Hello and welcome back. So this video is going to be going over my Victoria Beckham Beauty collection. And by collection, I just mean three products because that's all I have so far, but I love what I have so far. So that's great. I wish I had more to try, and I think I'll slowly be building up more products over time. So I guess let me know if you have any recommendations. But I guess I wanted to just kind of go over the things that I have been loving from this brand. I think I started trying things out maybe a year ago or so. So I've been using these like for a while, and a lot of them are go-tos, honestly. So that's very cool. I'll just get into it. I'm wearing all of the three products I have on my face today, which include the Lid Luster in Mink, the Satin Kajal Eyeliner in Bordeaux, and the Posh Lipstick in Play. So here's a bit of a closer look at how everything meshes together on my face, but I will be demoing them up close so you can get a better sense of how they perform going on the skin. And to start out, let's talk about the Lid Luster in Mink. This retails for $36. She has quite a nice handful of shades now, but this one in Mink is by far my favorite. It is so stunning, so unique. I am a huge fan. This is probably like the most standout thing, and then also it's the product that drew me to her brand the most. I saw someone swatch it or was demoing it in a video, and I thought, man, like, that looks so special. It's not quite a cream shade, but it does have some emollients to it. It has like almost a wet moist feeling when you pick it up, and because of that there's almost no fallout as you're applying it. I think that it is really unique because it has this like, well, obviously when you first put it on it's like super gunmetal-y, super pigmented, super shiny, and like has this wet slick look, and I love that. But then it also is really easy to work with either with the fingers or the brush, and as I kind of buff out the edges I notice that so like here's where it's packed on the most thick, but then where the pigment kind of spreads out there is some like sheerness to it and some warmth that peeks out from the shade instead. So it's really cool how there is both like extremely cool tones and also a little bit of like a built-in warm transition color almost. Like I only have this shadow on, and I feel like you can kind of see how it is like super dimensional, right? It's so reflective and shiny on the center of my lids, but it also like catches light nicely with like a little bit of flecks of glitter in my crease, I think, and it like shears out and blends out and like becomes a bit more warm in where it meets the rest of my skin. So I really like how it can transform depending how much you layer the product, and it can be like either something super cool toned and deep, or it can be something worn as like a sheer wash for something maybe a little bit more casual, or like something in between. And if you do decide to build it up, I think it's the easiest way to achieve a nice smoky eye. I really struggle with smoky eyes personally. I just like always find it to be too ghastly or like too much on me. I need to practice, but this product makes it so easy, and I feel like this would look stunning on pretty much anyone. Yeah, big fan of this product. It is $36, which is pretty ridiculous. I've heard the texture being compared to the L'Oreal Infallible shadow before, and I definitely see how someone would come to that conclusion. I have one myself, so I was kind of swatching between the two, and they both have this like, it's not a wet cream formula, but it doesn't feel dry at all. It almost feels like there is a bit of like moist emollientsness to it just because it's so smooth in texture and so reflective. The thing that makes this stand out is, one, obviously the packaging. I think it's so stunning and so luxe, and then also the shade Mink in particular is very unique in how it performs. I like haven't really come across a shadow like this, and of all of my like Luxe cream single shadows, I know this isn't really a cream, but I've been trying more like I've been trying the Hourglass Scattered Lights and like the Charlotte Tilbury Eyes to Mesmerize formula. I think that's what the cream formula is called, and a few others, and this one is like the most worth it that I would recommend out of all of them. So yeah, anyways, enough of that gushing. Let me move on to the eyeliner in Bordeaux. The main reason I like this so much is just because of the color. I don't quite have any eyeliner like this in my collection. It is like super smooth. I barely have to touch it with like the lightest smudge, and it's like super pigmented, super smooth, very easy to work with. My favorite way to apply this is just to make like a rough outline and then use a smaller detailed brush to draw out like an actual wing, and the formula like gives me a lot of time to work with it. It's so emollient that I actually thought that it would slip and slide throughout the day, but in fact what really surprised me and impressed me about the formula was that it stayed put like wherever I blended it out. Yeah, it's possible I just don't work with like nice pencil liners enough. I didn't have like many pencil liners in my collection at all for a while, but I was super impressed by how smooth this was, and then for how much time I had to kind of work with the formula before it set in place, I was impressed with how good the lasting power was, at least on my eyes. And I know that you can get like pretty colors like this, especially in like the Urban Decay lineup. I think they have a lot of beautiful shades. I'm not super sure how the formula compares. For me, it's some mix between like the color of this and the formula being really nice and pleasant to work out for me, that I really enjoy it. It is $28 though, so I don't think that this is something I would like instantly go out and recommend to most people. I do think that you can find something like a pencil eyeliner that'll work and that'll be able to achieve this similar look for cheaper for sure. Another thing to note is that there's a little smudge brush on the end. I pretty much never use this, but there also is no twist up. You have to sharpen it. That's really all I have to say about the Satin Kajal liner. Really love that it's in my collection. I think it'll last me a long time, but I would hesitate to repurchase. I would probably look for an alternative in a similar color for a cheaper price point. And then finally, I want to mention the Victoria Beckham Beauty Posh Lipstick. And again, it's in that, what is this? Turtle something. Not turtleneck. Oh, tortoise shell coloring, and it has a very slim component with a very secure click. It is super sleek and slim, which I like. It's super sturdy. It doesn't really feel like it would get damaged at all. And the color I have in play is actually, it perfectly matches the, sorry for this horrible swatch. It perfectly matches the liner I have in Bordeaux. So I actually really like the look that I have on with all of these together right now. It's like a little bit vampy, perfect for fall. It's like a little bit smoky, but again, like because mink is so versatile to work with, it's not like overwhelmingly like, ooh, I'm kind of goth. Anyways, so the best way that I like to wear play is I just dab it really haphazardly onto my lips here and there, and then I'll use my finger to really smudge it into my lips, and then I'm left with like this very natural but pigmented, like just been like my lips but better, and the result I think is super, it brings a lot of life to my skin. It adds like a really nice contrast and amount of color, but it also, because like the layer I have is so thin and it really is blended into like my lip texture, so you can see my like lip skin peeking through, it looks very natural almost despite like being such a different color. I really like the effect, and it also lasts really well on me because the layer of pigment I have on is so thin. It's like almost transfer proof at this point because it's just like such. Anyways, this formula spreads out really, really beautifully. That's my favorite way to wear this product. And like having a really nice thin layer of this, it stays in place well. I think it looks pretty flattering. It like wears really well under masks. So that's how I most enjoy it. Right now in this video, I have it on a little bit more like medium full pigment. The formula is incredibly emollient. I don't feel that comfortable. Just like at this point, there is a lot of transfer. If I eat or drink water, it's getting on the other surfaces. So I don't usually wear this like full on and go out. It like works well for this video, but if I was gonna wear something with this depth of color for a long time, I would probably opt for a different formulation. I think once blotted down a little bit, it works really, really well for me, but if it's just like I've just applied a thick layer of it, I feel very worried that like it'll slip outside of my lip lines and kind of get everywhere when I'm not looking. I would be curious to try a lighter shade of this color just to see how I like that. Like, it's a very buttery and like moisturizing formulation, so I think it would be like really cushioning, and it does give like quite a lot of sheen. So I think in a more like truly like my lips but better sort of color, I think the formulation would lend itself nicer to just kind of slapping on a thick layer. But I guess my like alternative way of applying this has turned this into a surprising favorite. When I first bought this and like tried putting it all over my lips, I was like, man, how do I? I don't know if I'm gonna be able to wear this all the time because it is quite pigmented, quite deep, quite slip slidey on me if I'm not like a little careful with it. So there is that. In general, I really like what I've tried from Victoria Beckham Beauty. I think she's one of the lines where it's certainly a luxury price point, but I do think that the formulation and packaging and like color choices and how everything performs on the skin does kind of make it worth that money. I've definitely tried stuff from luxury priced brands where like I feel like Charlotte Tilbury, though the formulations are beautiful, a lot of her packaging feels like kind of light, kind of flimsy, surprisingly. And then conversely, there are many things where like maybe the packaging feels really fancy, but the formulation is like really nothing special, nothing that seems like you couldn't get it at the drugstore. But like for me, I think all of these perform pretty uniquely in my collection. Obviously, I gushed a lot about MINK. I think this is definitely the most like standout thing that I've tried so far. But all of these, with the way that I like to use them, definitely perform really, really well. I feel really confident and beautiful when I reach for them. That is my quick overview on Victoria Beckham Beauty. Again, really like what I've tried from this brand so far. Would love to hear any recommendations on if you guys have any personal favorites of what to maybe try next, because I definitely keep tabs on this brand. I would like if they ever had a sale, that would be exciting. Okay, yeah, let me know if you have any thoughts, and thank you for watching.